Look at your neighbor. Look at who's sitting next to you. Come on, do it. you certainly know each other now. But think about what is his or her political orientation, about its or her religion, or what he eats, pork, does it have alcohol or not? This is an environment very special because it's full of differences. It is full of something that we don't understand. It is very particular. So there's one question, say, how do we call this situation, this room full of difference? Well, there are many words in many languages. The seminal language is in French, so let's start there. And I think we can start by saying it may be called multicultural. So I'm introducing this concept, multiculturalism. But what does that stand for? Well, the theory of multiculturalism believes that culture have a certain autonomy. They're like abstract constructs that evolve separately from one another, like I said. And we have a multicultural situation where different cultures are in a certain space and they start communicating, interacting. So from a multicultural perspective, this room is like a cubic bottle here. So this is a bottle and a container. And this bottle is filled with people, different people. Like on this map, you see girls, you see boys, different culture too. And that's what I'm aiming for, different culture. People have a certain background, education, religion, preferences. That's why they all have a particular culture. And we can say that they actually are cultural atoms. Here, atoms. So we have a container. We have atoms, cultural atoms, like each singularity. This is the room. Only atoms are people and they're cultural. And together, they tend to interact, to communicate, to share, to build bridges. So when you have atoms that build bridges, you got a molecule. This molecule is interesting because it's made of differences. It's made of singularity. It's made of different culture. This molecule is interesting because it's full of people are motivated, that should provide innovative ideas, set up initiatives, and foster civic engagement. That's why this molecule is interesting. That's why this place is actually very amazing. But can we think of another word to qualify this room? Multiculturalism sees a cubic bottle, but is that really that? I mean, what does multicultural mean? It means that there's culture, they're different, they interact, they are all peaceful to one another. Is that frequent? I mean, I can think of many dramatic examples where culture placed one to another end up without good communication and they start a fight or violence. That's why I think it's important to maybe question this concept and this poetic vision. Yes, it's great to be here, but I think there's maybe another word that can qualify this situation. I mean, multiculturalism believes that culture are singular. This means that my identity, it's very different from my neighbor's identity. I'm like, the concept is transculturalism. I forgot to remember it, to say it. So like, culture as seen in multiculturalism are like boxes, you know, the closed boxes. I'm inside of the people I look like are inside the boxes. And it's actually a common and kind of dangerous vision. I see dangerous because when I define myself as one person, one cultural atom, I use a relation of opposition because I myself, I have one culture, I have my people, and they are the others with their culture, with their people. So there's a real relation of opposition in the process of defining who I am. And this can be dangerous. The multiculturalism kind of stands on this concept. We are who we are because they are not who I am. So there's a real notion of exclusion, which is dangerous. This system is therefore composed of two pieces, we and they, I mean them. But there's a third way. Some people, some philosophers, argue there's another category, which can be called the category differences. It's a great one because we all belong to it. because from another person's perspective, we're different. So instead of this dual system, rigid system, we had one that includes a very welcoming category, because we all belong to it. That's why it's important to maybe differ from this concept, multiculturalism, and explore another one, like transculturalism. We are far from this opposition, we are far from this, all these boxes, and in fact, the word transculturalism is interesting because you have cultures, and you have the Latin prefix trans, which can mean across, but also beyond. And beyond is interesting again because I'm not looking beyond differences, because they are different, people are different, I see the differences. I'm looking beyond my own box. I'm getting out of this box where everything is stable, and I'm seeing something else, something maybe bigger than other boxes. And I'm seeing the end of the box like this, you see? That's why I think transculturalism is a great approach to differences. And now if we look at this room from a transcultural point of view, it's not a bottle with atoms building connection. Is it beautiful and poetic, but not too realistic sometimes? And I think that when you look at from a transcultural point of view, what we see is that we see open boxes and what people emerge from them, and they look at each other. And it's really interesting because we don't see a bubble, we don't see borders. What happens is that how outside expands, we see further. And that's really interesting because we are there able to acknowledge differences. We don't say everything goes perfectly. We see differences. Sometimes they're not really comfortable to be around, but we see them, we acknowledge them, we're opening up to them, and we see the big picture. So this seminar is not about building a multicultural molecule, which is great again, but I think it's about being further and farther. It's about when we get back to our communities where identities, cultural identities are really stable, when we're able to teach or maybe to encourage our neighbors to see as far as we can. Thank you.